Hello everyone. When tsunami hit India's southeastern coast, hundreds of people were killed and lives of thousands of others were shattered. During this period, a Bollywood hero made an unexpected entry at the scene of devastation and started working hand in hand with the rescue teams. He spent weeks with other volunteers building huts for those who lost their homes to the tsunami. He was Vivek Oberoi. He personally delivered food packets to individual homes and helped in setting up community kitchens and medical facilities. The question is, why? Success is defined differently by different people. Some may want to become rich, while some dream to be famous. To some others, success means achieving a greater significance professionally or socially. But what after we get what we had wanted? Is success a destination or just a milestone? Well, for some of us, aspirations don't end with success. They might actually begin with it. And I'm talking about people like Vivek Oberoi, who had everything they could have asked for, but still wanted something which was missing from their lives. And that is why, when asked why he personally traveled to the tsunami hit areas, he responded by saying that sending a check was not enough for me. Vivek followed his heart and his passion to find the purpose of his life during those few weeks that he spent in the villages of Tamil Nadu. Well, he is not alone. Remember Sonu Sood's selfless help to the people stranded during the lockdown? And if we have a look around, we will be able to identify many people like us who are trying to give that extra bit to their passion, to the society, something that really makes them happy. One of my colleagues who is passionate about football is officiating as the coach for a children's football team in the neighborhood. A friend who is an IT professional and passionate about teaching can be found with the children of a slum area in Gurgaon every weekend. They say people who are following a passion can be spotted from a mile away. After all, why did Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam continue to visit universities, colleges and schools, trying to make a deep connection with the youth, even though he could have just enjoyed his tenure sitting quietly in the Rashtrapati Bhavan? Different people may be passionate for different things, but almost every kind of passion can be channeled as a force for greater good, and it can make a positive impact on others without affecting our ability to focus on our primary tasks and objectives. In fact, it is observed that people with a sense of purpose are more engaged in their work, as living their personal values gives them a deep sense of fulfillment. Let me share my own experience. Right from my childhood days, I have felt deep pain for the sufferings of the people with disability. They are not at fault for their physical or emotional characteristics, but they suffer. They are not at fault for the social attitudes, but they face the barriers. They are physically weak, emotionally drained, and most often less educated, unemployed, and poor. But they are the ones who have to face some of the toughest challenges in their lives. My heart goes out for them, and I feel sad for the unending series of struggles they find themselves going through. But feeling someone's pain is of no use unless you can do something to reduce it or at least share it. I remember as a child I used to fight with people who disrespected people with disability or misbehaved with them. Whenever I found a homeless person with disability, I used to take that person to an NGO working for their welfare. But getting them shelter was not so easy after all, and I often had to fight with the reluctant NGO officials as well, arguing vehemently, employing all my emotions and vigor. When I learnt programming, the first thing I did was to develop websites for two unknown NGOs working in this space and maintain these websites for years. Working with the people with disability was something that gave me immense sense of gratification, and it turned into my passion. When I joined Microsoft, I realized this is the place where my passion and my work can go hand in hand. Here was an organization that was genuinely interested in making a difference to people's lives. It talked about empowering every single person on the planet. It had an inclusive culture, and it encouraged and appreciated people with passion for a positive social change. There was no dearth of opportunities, both internal as well as external, to follow my passion, especially when I started participating in the D&I Council and the Disability ERG. The organization not only allowed me to pursue my passion, but actually valued it. It asked me to lead the accessibility charter inside my MWP business group and also gave me an opportunity to co-lead the Global One Commercial Accessibility Program in India. It was a double delight for me because on one side, my passion and my values were in harmony with my professional life, and on the other side, my passion had led me right into my purpose. Working in accessibility space has given me valuable opportunities which could not have been otherwise possible. I represented Microsoft at important conferences, committees, forums, and even fairs and festivals organized for people with disability, children with disability. I have worked with NGOs, disability leaders, government departments, PSUs, corporates, development teams, startups, educational institutions, media organizations, disability champions, some celebrities, and even some ministers. I have made friends inside the accessibility space and outside of it also. I have networked with like-minded people internally and externally. This has led to valuable learnings for me and myself being familiarized with diverse perspectives. What I have loved the most is the process to be able to make a difference to people's lives, sometimes by sharing information in the shape of articles published in different newspapers in local languages as well, and sometimes helping our customers to empower their disabled employees, sometimes by taking assistive technology sessions for Divyangjans, and sometimes connecting with the teachers and parents of children with disability. The sense of fulfillment you get when your entire audience consists of people with visual disability or hearing disability, and when they express their appreciation and love like this, that is unmatched. The feeling is unmatched. These are moments that assure you that you are living a meaningful life and you have found your purpose, something that is bigger than you. When you are following your purpose, it is a destination in itself. Whether you get recognized for what you do or not is immaterial. But most often, your work gets noticed. I am delighted to share the news of recently announced Rajbhasha Gaurav Puraskar for my Hindi book on Microsoft's accessibility technologies. The book is called Hauslon Ko Udhne Do, Divyangon Ke Liye Takneek, and the award is to be conferred by the President of India. I hope this development will generate interest among many more people to work in this space or in any other area where there are man-made barriers that stop people from realizing their potential and living happy lives. I also hope many more people will follow their passion and in the process find their purpose, because to me, purpose is a larger objective to achieve than success can be. Thank you so much.